This is one of my favorite games I love playing so much. It's a game of chess. Now, this game is this. I'll just put it through before we go to the business of the day. It's about strategic planning. This game has to do with a whole lot of things. You focus, you understand, you analyze everything you need to know. These are the pawns. This is your castle. This is your knight. This is your bishop. And this is your queen, this is your king. Every move on this board counts. Every move on this chessboard matters. You must understand how you need to make your next move before you do it. E.g., this pawn only move one step forward. Why this move straight or this way? This move in an L shape. That is the knight. Then why this move only in this direction? And all this, there are rules. So if a chess game, if a chessboard game has rules, then in business there are rules.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Abraham Orukwe.
Hello, how are you doing? I'm Abraham Orukwe by name. I'm a business consultant. I help MSMEs owners to understand their market, give them business visibility, and scale up their profit. Today, I'll be sharing with you two vital things you need to understand in business: your value proposition and the importance of strategic management in your business. Over time, I've worked with business owners from all walks of life. I realize that most of them, just the way these chess boards have rules and games on this game, so the business have it, but people always fail to study the rules of the game in business, but they just want to play. They just want to move their product and services left and right. They just want to feel the meta feeling of, oh, I can have a chess board. Or I have a business. Everything in life works with rules and regulation. So also in business. But every time you fail to understand the rules in your niche market, you struggle, you move in circles, and you waste resources, you waste time, and your creativity is burned out. Today in this section, I'll be sharing with you quickly the essence of you understanding your value proposition in your business. Value proposition simply means your unique selling point. That thing you are good at doing. That thing you can do closing your eyes. That's your unique selling point. Then now bring me to inform of value proposition, which is broken into two areas. Either your product or your service. I take it again. Your value proposition is your solution you are offering to your target audience. Either as a product or a service. I'll share with you in this session, as I said before, your value proposition canvas. This simply just states that how do you intend to take your solution to meet the need of your target audience? This canvas has to do with two aspects, your product and your service, and your customer. Under this canvas, it has to do with you as a business owner. You need to first understand your customer wants. What do your customer want? Remember, what your customer wants is totally different from what they need. That's why you see when most customers that call you, you're being told that, hello, how are you doing? I want this. I want that. I want this. They are just like babies in the front of a buffet. You give them a knife and a spoon. Just take what you want. Majority of customers and clients have an idea of what they want, but they don't know what they need. That's why you, as a professional, as a business owner, who have the solution you intend to offer to them for to attract a reward called money in form of service or profit, need to make them understand, okay, I've listened to you. I've heard all you want. But this solution will give you what you need and not what you want. This is how a business person should interact with the target audience. Now, what do you want? Customer knows what they want, but they don't know what they need. That's why you need to tailor your solution to ensure it suits your customer need under the value proposition, under the value proposition canvas. I've told you, your customer, you need to know what your customer need from what they want. E.g., I might come to tell you, I need a green shirt. I want a green shirt with a green tie, with a green cap, with a green trouser. That is what I want. But it's your duty as a fashion designer to make me know that this is what you want, but I believe this is what you need. How about you using a green shirt with a white tie, since you are in Nigeria, with a green face cap, show green, white, green, just making joke for that. So your goal is that you should always direct your customers to what they need, not what they want, with your professional skills. Now, after you're able to sort out what they need from what they want with your solution, you need to tackle their fear. Every customer have a hidden fear of three things. They don't want to waste their money. They wonder and think if the solution offer will solve their problem, which is their pain point. Or they don't want to experience something of the same nature they went through in the last product or service that they bought. You are able to balance these three things. Your customer wants, their need, and their fear puts them at the right spot in this chess game, in this business game where you want them to be. You should be able to be, you should be smart enough as a business owner to first define your value proposition. What solution are you offering? This will enable you to answer these three things in your customer's life. What they want, what they need, and what they are scared of, which is as a result of fear. Every time a customer pick up a phone and ask you, do you have XYZ? There is a pain point that they want to satisfy. It's a pain point that they want to heal. It's your duty to understand the underlying tone behind their request. Pay more attention to what they are not saying from what they are telling you to do. After able to identify these three things, you move to the next side of your business model canvas, which has to do with one, the user experience. Everybody needs an experience. Everybody needs something memorable. Every time your customer comes here and tell you, I need 1, 2, 3, your goal is to strategically think of what best we suit in to make it fit well for them. Your customer experience will lead to customer referrals. People will forget what you say. People will forget how you said what you said, but they will not forget how you made them feel. That saying still plays a long role in business solution. You must ensure you give your customer the wow effect, going the extra miles to make them wow. Many business owners today stop at what they are being paid for. No, the extra services which come as a pro bonus, as a discount, is what will make your customer need look more appealing to them, thereby healing their fear, satisfying their wants, and making them need more to make them come back and rebuy from you. Or better still, give you a referral. So you must be more interested in giving your customers the wow effect, going the extra miles, giving them something that will make them keep coming back for different products you are offering. Now you've talked about the experience, you'll now be looking at the features. Learn to sell features to your customers, not product or brand or services. Most people or business owners repeatedly has failed to understand what it is they are giving to their customers. Always ensure that you give your customer the features of what they want to buy. It's called specifications. You want to buy a phone, you pick up the carton, what you see behind, you see specifications. What this phone can do, what this laptop can do, what this chessboard can do, those are specifications. Here in my home country, Nigerians, there are people that sells product and services inside a moving bus. Like in the Lagos is like commercial hub of the country, Nigeria, you understand that most at times, people sell inside the bus. What do? They sell the features to you. This will do X, Y, Z. This will do X, Y, Z. So always be smart enough to tell your customers what this solution you are offering will do for them. Will do for them. Don't just tell them, come and buy. People are tired of that word BUY. Always learn to sell features, benefits, return on investment to them. You are built to always show your customers the benefit of what they stand to gain from transacting with your product and services will make them buy faster than telling them product available for sales. Let's now look at it. This is a turtleneck I'm putting on. Your goal as a seller is to make me understand that a turtleneck will be good for me during what? Rainy season. If I'm the kind of person that does not really like cold, sell this thing for me. I can use this turtleneck just the way I'm wearing it. I can put it on inside the suit, or I can choose to wear it on a pant trouser, on a chinos trouser, or on a jeans trouser. These are features of how I can use this turtleneck. Learn to sell features and benefits, not product or packaging. You might convert sales in product and packaging, but when you sell features and benefits, it's more easier to convert. When I mean convert, to make people buy from you, that's what I mean by the word convert. And after you're looking at the experience you're giving to them, you talk about the benefit, the features you're giving them, then I show them what will be the return of investment from them patronizing you. Return investment simply means what will be the end user effect on them. This is what your value proposition canvas simply states in this session. Learn to show them what paint an image in the mind of your client, in the mind of your customers, to make them feel if they don't buy that thing from you, they are losing that big time. Make me feel putting on this turtleneck, Mr. Abraham, is going to make you look super cool. You are fair. Putting on a black turtleneck will bring out your color and make you look more handsome. You are painting a picture in my mind. It will make you go for meeting with confidence. You can wear it to your church service. You can wear it to your speaking engagement. Putting on this, you can wear it on what? A white suit, a red suit, a black suit, an ash color suit. Black goes for all color. You can use this on a black bed with a black shoe. You are showing me return on investment in my mind. With that, you are locking me in to ensure I go on for your call to action to pay you and buy from you. This is what your value proposition canvas simply states. Tackle your customer fear, handle their want, and work on their need. Show them the user experience by giving them sufficient user information to make them buy from you, and showing them the features and benefits of specification of your product and services to why they should give you the money which you are looking for, right? And also show them the return on investment, that what they stand to gain when they buy these things from you. Now we're going to talk and look quickly what value proposition canvas. We'll now look at strategic planning. As I said in the beginning of this session, this is a chessboard. This requires a high level of strategy. I love playing this game. It's a game that I love. It makes me think strategically on what to do, because you must be careful of your next move. So in business, we have limited resources. Resources that are not sufficient for us to do what we want to do. That is why we must be strategic in our business. Strategic management simply states that your ability for you to coordinate, plan, identify, and manage the limited resources you have in your business. Let's say you're having $1 million as a business owner. How do you effectively coordinate these resources, this cash, convert it to product and services, meet your customer need and want to heed their fear, give them the user experience they're looking for by showing them the features and benefits of what they will get from your product and service, and give them a return on investment which goes in two ways. You make profit, they gain satisfaction. is strategic management for you. But you doing this, you need to understand that the first part of strategic management you need in your business should be financial management. What's your cash flow like? How do you manage the inflow and outflow of cash? Your goal is to reduce expense at all costs. Your overhead costs need to be brought down in order to maximize your profit. These are areas as a business owner, you need strategic management system or knowledge or acumen to understand this thing. Cash is king. Cash is the lifeline of every business. But you need to understand how best you need to do these things. Now we talk about your financial management, we talk about your profit and loss account, your bookkeeping, your recording system. How do you pay? When do you pay your vendors? Is it every 28th of every month? Is it 25th? Is it every 30th? You must ensure you coordinate your cash flow system in your business. You don't just pay every day. No, there are times, it's a game, it's a strategy. There are times you hold your payment to your vendor. I tell you, I'm going to pay you every on the 28th of this month. What happened? You're using their money to trade, to enable you run other business. You know, you've been wondering, so you're holding somebody else's money in your business. It's called business strategic in financial management. Let's come about product and services. How do you intend to do your sales? What is your sales target? It's an error for you not to have a sales target in your business. Get a monthly, daily, weekly, quarterly, annually sales target for your business. Remember, the goal is to minimize cost. Under your financial, how do you intend to, what's your revenue stream like? How many products or services can you get from one of your products? Maybe you are into a particular fashion. You can do training as a fashion designer. You can sew. You can sell material. You can do consultation. That is first stream of revenue income in that business already.
So the next thing we'll be looking at now is your operational productivity. In strategy management in business, you need to fairly understand. The first one I said, you need to first get your financial strategy. You need to now get your operational productivity. What are the things you need to cut costs down on? How should your operation move from point A to point B? These are the things you need to ask yourself. Because in business, operational cost can kill a business if not well managed. E.g. expenses, advertisements cost, rent, services, fuel, different expenses. If you do not put your operational cost in check, it can ruin and drain your business. So you should be able to understand that when it comes to business, your operational productivity matters a lot. What are the activities that genuinely produce for you? Now, looking at things like Pareto principle, we see that 80% of the results you get come from 20% of the things you get right. Just like in this chessboard, the win you make is directly linked to what? Your calculation strategy on this board. So you see in business, your ability for you to understand what you need to do should be in line with the productivity of your business. Looking at what? Management performance. How are your team managing? How are they performing? Most at times, people miss this whole thing when it comes to business in general. You need to be smart enough to analyze your strategic management when it comes to business management. Build your team. Get the right people. Understand what exactly it is you want to do in your niche market. Draw KPIs, key performance indication. How do you tend to measure your staff's input? What is their bottom line productivity in your business? You need to be smart enough to understand this whole thing when it comes to business management. Also, looking at your employment performance, it's still the same to your management performance. Because in business, you have management team, you have general team. Your management team should be a team that think and take decisions to know where the business should be heading through. While your other team members are the ones are unique foot soldiers, just like I can call this, like say on this chess game, these pawns should be your foot soldiers who are your general employee. Why these bad guys should be what? Your management team. You need to go to synchronize them together to work hand in hand for productivity. They're not looking at your sales target and your marketing. What is your strategy around this whole thing? Then what are your customer relationship? How do you intend to build an effective customer relationship in line with your sales target? Remember, sales and marketing are two different things. Marketing is your ability for you to show your business, to make it visible to the right audience. Why sales is the ability for you to convert and send cash for your product and services. A quick recap. The areas you need strategic management in your business. Number one, your financial strategy, your financial management. Number two, your operational management. Number three, your management productivity. Number four, your employee performance. Number five, your marketing and sales strategy. And number six, your customer relationship. I believe with these two aspects of your business fully checked and running, you are in for a profitable business. Thank you very much for liking our post. Thank you for sharing with us and appreciate. Bye.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Abraham Orukwe.